Hi. In this video we are going to show you another way to create presets for single row, multi-row, and partial panoramas using URL parameters. This method works as expected for the default value of preferred MSS pattern. We'll give you more details on this later. Connect to MECHA's network using your smartphone, for example. Next, enter the following URL in the browser address bar: 192.168.8.1/preset?b=1, and s=12, and p=2. This will create a preset for 12 shots around. More precisely, the factory preset button 1 will be overwritten. Button 1 is a preset that can be launched by pressing the 1 button on the MECHA controller, and either the left or right button. Then tap the Go button. The page may ask you to enter your username and password, which are admin and MECHA with capital M, by default. If you are using a MECHA Dual Axis Combo, or any Dual Axis MECHA, make sure the upper rail of the panohead is in the level position. With MECHA DAC, press and hold either the right or left arrow button of the upper MECHA to rotate the upper rail as required. To launch the preset created by MECHA, press the 1 button, then the right arrow button. You can press the left arrow button to rotate in the opposite direction. The preset is saved in the MECHA's memory, so the next time you want to shoot this type of panorama, all you have to do is power on MECHA and use this button combination to launch the preset. Remember that the upper rail of the panohead must be in the correct position. With MECHA C2 controller, you need to use the minus, plus, and menu buttons to enter the numbers 1, 2, and 3, respectively. Let's see now how to shoot spherical and partial panoramas. The parameters passed in the URL tell MECHA how to create the preset, and they are as follows. The first parameter is B, and it tells MECHA to which button to assign the preset. You will launch the preset by pressing this button, and either the left or right arrow button. All possible values of the B parameter are 1, 2, and 3, as MECHA controller has 3 numerical buttons. This parameter is required. The second parameter, S, is the number of shots around for a single row panorama. For example, this URL will create a preset for 6 shots around. The third parameter, F, is the focal length required for a multi-row panorama. For example, this will create a preset for a full 360 degrees panorama for a 30mm lens, FF equivalent. And this, a preset for a full 360 degrees panorama for a 50mm lens, FF equivalent. If both S and F are specified, S will be ignored. The fourth parameter, P, is the pause after each shot, in seconds, and it is optional. The default value is 1 second. For example, P=2 means a pause of 2 seconds after each shot. Starting with firmware version 02134, you can use H and V parameters to specify the height and width of a partial panorama, in degrees. For example, this will create a preset for a partial panorama for 80mm lens, 100 degrees wide, and 75 degrees tall. The focal length is required in this case. If you are using a single-axis MECHA to execute a dual-axis preset, you need to manually tilt to the upper rail of the panahead, or cancel the preset after the first row, by pressing the power button, while MECHA is waiting for you to tilt the upper rail. This will result in a single row panorama. For more details, please see Programming a Preset Using Parameters in either C1 or C2 User's Guide. Once connected to the MECHA's network, it is very easy to access the config page and check the preferred MSS pattern we've mentioned at the beginning of this video. MSS comes from MECHA Simple Scripting, and refers to the preset scripts that MECHA automatically creates, taking into account this setting as well. The default preferred MSS pattern is SL, MDU, ZZ, and N. The first term is the start position of the upper rail. SL means start position, level. It can be parked and raised as well. So, if you change it to SB, for example, make sure the upper rail is set in the parked position before launching the preset. The next is the order of the rows, by default, middle row first, then down, then up. It can be DMU, or MD, or M, and so on. Then the number of zenith and nadir shots, by default, 2 zenith and 2 nadir shots. You can delete both if you don't need them. Tap the apply button to save your new settings. You can also create presets for panoramas, using the controller buttons, or features available in the user interface, or in C2's OLED menu. We will put some links below in the description of the video. Thank you for watching.